Artemis served as an Astartes of the Mortifactors during the 41st millennium. Recruited into the Mortifactors from the barbaric nomadic tribes of the feral world of Pusul, Artemis would be one of the most gifted warriors within his tribe. Claiming the skeletal remains of his enemies as trophies, Artemis would in turn accrue many enemies due to his reputation and skill. Artemis would even survive an ambush consisting of 50 tribesmen, yet be heavily wounded during the fight. Saved by the actions of a chaplain of the Mortifactor's Space Marine chapter, his skill in battle would be recognized by the Astartes, with the apothecaries of the chapter healing his wounds and inducting Artemis into the chapter. Achieving victory and surviving hundreds of campaigns as an Astartes of the Mortifactors, Artemis would distinguish himself as an expert at combating the Xenos of the galaxy. Piquing the interest of the Ordo Xenos, Artemis would be seconded to the Ordo Militant Deathwatch Company of the Inquisition. Serving under Inquisitor Severnius whilst combating the Genestealer cults on the world of Saint Capeline, Artemis would aid in preventing the Tyranid Xenos from harvesting the world's populace. Promoting Artemis to serve as his second in command, Severnius would fight alongside and mentor his new brother-in-arms for 2 decades. Thwarting the Harud species on the planet of Varnex Prime from capturing an Adeptus Mechanicus base, Severnius's kill team would be highly regarded for their deeds. Answering the call to arms from the colonel of the Calson Imperial Guard Regiment on Assumptus V of the Denorian sector, Artemis would slay the Xenos Knib species and end their incursion into Imperial space. During this campaign, the Xenos would attempt to dominate the minds and bodies of the kill team. With 3 Astartes falling under their control, Artemis would cut them down as they turned on their former battle brothers, killing 2 in their rampage. Alongside Severnius and 2 of their battle brothers, they would face the hordes of thralls. Holding back their enemies within a small temple devoted to the Emperor, while Severnius cast a psychic shield, the kill team would survive for 6 days until being rescued by a Thunderhawk gunship. Yet Severnius would fall before the arrival of the gunship, too weakened due to the strain of the use of his psychic powers. Artemis would declare exterminatus of the planet and would be appointed as the Watch Captain of Talasa Prime for his continual service to the Death Watch. Gifted with an incredible sensitivity to discern the taint of Xenos, Artemis would foil a ritual cast by Eldar Farseer Eldrad Ulthran during the Battle of Port Demesnus and ignore the Xenos' pleas to cooperate in the attempt to slay the so-called God of the Ruinous Powers, Slaanesh. With Artemis stating that he would rather see humanity fall to the Ruinous Powers than trust the word of a Xenos. His actions in preventing the ritual saving the lives of billions of humans. Rooting out and destroying many infestations of the Xenos throughout the galaxy, Artemis upholds the honor of his chapter and the glory of the Ordo Xenos in his persecution of the aliens of the galaxy.